Hi guys, I'm Joao. Thank you for watching this video. This is the weekly Falcon Crusade podcast with Joao, and this week is the New Year week. So in a few days, it'll be 2018. So I wish everybody a happy New Year, a productive 2018, something I really want to have as well. I will have. So it's good to say you will do it, or you're doing it, rather than I want to or I wish I could, right? It's some sort of like positive mentality thingy, something to do with positive psychology, something like that. Anyway, so what's up this week? This week we're gonna have Abyssal Archwitch, we're gonna have lots of reward getting from the Stolas Sisters event. I have over 200 rewards I am about to get. And also, I forgot what else, right, comrade kicking and alliance member kicking. So if you want to join an alliance, join a cool alliance like my alliance, join the active alliance, we have a few spaces left. So just add me, 71R94, 71R94, and you can join my awesome alliance, my beautiful, huge alliance, which is half full at the moment. So hey, come on, half full, that's pretty good. So I kicked a bunch of people you can see here, and I recorded it, and I forgot to make fun of the name. So I guess a spook, you're too spooky, so that's why I invited you out. And Diamond Dust turned to dust, all of them haven't logged in quite a while. So but if you wanna have listened to me making fun of people's names, it would be in the comrade kicking session. Okay, so let's go straight to Abyssal Archwitch, and then let's get the ball rolling from there. And if you like this video, remember to leave me a like, subscribe to my channel, and if you think you will like my video, leave me a like, and subscribe to my channel, leave a comment, say Happy New Year to everybody, say Happy New Year to me, say Happy New Year to, or just leave a random message. Okay, so apparently I need a copy of this card, Astronaur, to get into the special area so I can get the book something, Bukuro, I forgot, like the bag or something. So I have all of these, like 200 of these Archwitches I haven't gotten the rewards from, so I'm gonna do it here. Hopefully get something awesome. Awakening Arcana is reasonably awesome. Or reason. Oh! Ooh! Ooh! Legendary summon ticket.
Wow.
No! Archon! You got two R cards.
What's that?
R cards is R.
It's a ticket.
Junk.
The legendary ticket.
I got the legendary ticket.
But I need to, yeah.
Okay, stop. Alright. Stop. No. Just like the mother. No. No. You wanna get things done? You have to do it yourself. What do you mean I didn't use a legendary card?
The legendary...
I just got the ticket.
Yes, you should use it.
I should use the ticket? Okay, I can use the ticket. Why not? I can use the ticket. Okay, you use the ticket. See what you get. Get me the... Let me see which one I want. I got that, I got this. Who is this? Okay, this is reasonable. Okay, get me this card. Get me this card.
Only you are? Where's the LR?
There are no LR tickets yet. Well, I have 16, we're not using it yet. Letta! No! Oh no! I don't know. Wasn't the one I wanted. It's not good. Oh, it's a really bad card. Oh no, the skills are useless. This is just bad. I saved for 2 weeks for this.
3 weeks.
Oh, look! No, it's an SR, never mind. I saw the background, I thought it's something good. Hey, look.
Ah, translator.
Yay. Oh, look.
Wow.
Last one. Yay. Oh, guarantee you our ticket. But that's not because of luck. It's a reward, fixed reward.
What's the fake surprise for?
Because I didn't know I was getting the fixed reward until I saw the pink color. that's the surprise, not the reward. So let's look at 9th Abyssal Arc Witch Hunt. So let's have a look at the rewards. I had a look at my cards and I will have already organized them in a proper way, and I tapped the wrong button. So I have quite a few event cards, actually. Quite a few event cards, and I've kind of stacked them together. Leveled them all up, actually. A waste of slime, maybe, but it's reasonable. I had a play yesterday without optimizing my cards, and that was a very bad idea. But yeah, so let's have a look at the Thor deck. My Thor deck, so it's at 1,437,000. Okay, so that's not a lot, to be honest, but I do have 25 Thor skills. So you can see here, there is I have quite a few cards that have been, well, not this one, that have been maxed out already. And yeah, so starting from Red Eye and wherever this is, Elemental Queen, and all the cards to the left have been maxed out. The attack has been maxed out. And then on the right, I should not have done this, I guess. Nope, I should have done it. Wait. Why is this arranged this way? So, okay, my bad. So anyway, I was saying that to the left of this card, nope. To the left of this card, nope. So I haven't really, okay, so, all right, I get it. To the left of, wait a minute, what's going on here? Okay, I'm definitely sure I've maxed out this card. Okay, to the left of Monkey, I have all these maxed out cards, and not many, actually. I've been trying to max out Passion cards only, and yeah, so, I mean, I'm maxing out for Abyssal Arc Witch only, so it doesn't make much sense to not have to have different kind of elements. I mean, I understand that each Abyssal Arc Witch event has a different set of like element that is preferred, but you know what? I might as well go for a strong one element like Passion team, so I can do well during the Passion Abyssal Arc Witch before I try to max out everything, you know? So it's a kind of a barbell approach to risk, if you read that type of risk management books. Anyway, so I only have one Herb Gnoir, and then I have a few of those Gem Gnoirs, I think they're called, or Petty Trite, my favorite card name, I guess. And then Amy, so I should not have HSR on Amy. I don't know why, I thought it would be a good idea to HSR on them, and I shouldn't have, but anyway, so I have quite a few of these event cards. So last time I did, without like with just half the event cards, I did 1 million. Was it 1 million? No, 10 million. Okay, and I was quite happy about it. I did 10 million. I can have a look at the, record, and I got a bunch of cards, which I tickets and arcana, which I will need to find where to. How do I participate in Abyssal Arc Witch? Right, there you go. Okay, there you go. You can see I only have 4 hammers left, and then I have done 10 million damage. Okay, as you can see here, and I got a bunch of rewards out of these. So I still don't know why they put guaranteed SR summon tickets in front of premium summon tickets, even though you could get UR cards in premium tickets, right? And then guaranteed UR and stuff. So I am looking to or hoping to get 20 million damage. That would be awesome, but that would be quite a tough try. I mean, I don't have the UR event cards, and so you know what? Let's talk and more action. So let's just try this. And I actually entered already. I thought they would be okay. So I'm thinking that my speedster team is enough to do that. And then I can use one hammer, and I should be able to go in. Probably the Hiraga would. Yeah, it's pretty much done. I don't even know why there is this step. Yeah, activate, obviously. What am I gonna do? Quit the game? Okay, so I have 25 Thor skills and I got 20, which is reasonable, I guess. So I did more than yesterday, but no dice. I mean, no seat, new record, no more of these rewards, I guess. So can I see my ranking? And they haven't ranked me yet, which is quite annoying. I don't know why Falcon Crusade can't have instant ranking. I mean, back in the day, Fantastica had instant ranking. All other games have instant ranking. Why does Falcon Crusade need to kind of fall behind the times, right? Doesn't that promote competition? Doesn't that entice people to try to pay more, use more items, and then MyNet can earn more money? Isn't that the thing? So hopefully, 23. Oh yeah, I can feel it. But I'll never get to 20,000. I mean, sorry, 20 million. So yeah, but it's good to go up in rank, I suppose. It's good to go up in rank. Okay, so yep, not even close. And to be honest, even if I do, how much is this? 80 million. Even if I do 80 million, I mean, so. Okay, legendary summon tickets, UR cards. So what? Who in their right mind is aiming for UR cards these days? Who? Right? We're all looking for LR cards. So I guess it's the ranking that matters. And I don't know how I rank. So, I mean, I don't know why I wasn't ranked, actually. Because I could see the number one and stuff people were. There was 100 million, wasn't it? The number one. So that's quite, activate. That was quite interesting. So I'll have a look. Maybe it drops off really quickly. I don't know. 23 again. Did I do a new record? I don't care really. Oh, I did do a new record. Okay. Not too shabby. Not too shabby, I guess. Do I have any more hammers? Do I? I'm not sure. I do. Okay. Okay, I'll use one more. Why not? And that's it for the Abyssal Arcwitch event, which is exactly what I said when they first introduced this event. It's a good gimmick, but it's not the type of event we want, okay? I think what we want is a shorter event, like shorter normal tower or normal event. Okay, 21, get lost. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay, a normal 21, not 21, normal tower or just a progression event and all that, or even the elemental hall event they tried some time ago, right before I quit. And then there's also another event that they tried some time ago. I remember they put in a Cleopatra that had the exact same mark but different element and different skills. That was not very generous or sincere of them. But yeah, I guess they're still experimenting. And so let's have a look at the ranks. Let's go all the way down to 100. See what they get. Okay, so it's 53 million. So, and the drop off looks steep or not steep. The drop off is not steep. So, I mean, it was really steep at the start. Okay, so that means I'll probably rank really low. Probably, I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised if I ranked 2 or 3,000. So, okay, it'd be great if I could rank 1,000. within 1,000, that would be awesome, but never mind. If it's just 2,000, it's still okay. Error chance ticket, which is something I got from, well, no spoilers, but you know, you could get error chance tickets from Legend of Rockwood drops. Maybe I'll get some. You never know. So, I guess that's it then. I guess that's it for this season's Abyssal Arcwitch. And is there anything I need to comment on? Nope. I don't even use the custom skills because I have two LR cards and they're not GLR yet. They're not in my team yet, so I don't know. I guess Norn's, I don't know. I want a passion card. I want a card that has better art, to be honest. And yeah, I mean, I'm playing for fun now, so I'm not really grinding for every single card I have. I used to have this mind that I wanted to do collections, but not anymore. And so right now it's just, you know, I'll have some fun and then make some videos. And with my decent team, I can rank if I want to, but most of the time I don't want to because the rewards aren't very nice and there are only two events per month. Right, ABB is fine, I guess, so... So that is it, I suppose. And let's go on to the other sessions. Hello, so this is going to be Comrade Kicking, and I've actually written a script, so hopefully it will be less unentertaining, is that a word, than improv. So let's start with Shot, which is more like Shot, because she hasn't, he or she hasn't, logged in for almost 250 days. Have a look at the kingdom as well, because it's shot as well. Look at the mess, right? So I guess it's called Hell. I guess it's an aptly named kingdom. So I'm gonna, oh, this is the correct, I'm gonna cancel. Okay, and then Gemini 2, more like Gemini. Goodbye. And Arhei is hard to pronounce, and also Arbai. This one's easy. And then Low Hex. well, okay, thanks, bye. And then this is Fa Tian Wang, which could mean the Divine King of Butchering. Or Lumbering, as in Fa Mu, which means lumbering. So, you know, think of a better name, dude. And then Tree Gwen actually still has 80 comrades, probably means they also quit. Ouch, really sad, too sad, must kick. Ferrari is missing a R because Ferrari is F-E-R-R-A-R-I, unacceptable kick. And then this is Long Xiao Xiao Lu, which means, it's a nice name, which means a little deer, with a dragon's roar. I guess he can force Dura out of there, Skyrim reference, wink wink. And then this name actually, a huge plus point for this person is that his level, his or her level, is 6'9". I like those two numbers. And and the name's quite funny to me because it's actually looks like a electronic store chain in my city. But the staff in that chain shop has really bad attitude, so... goodbye. Nanko, generic name, not even gonna comment. Goodbye. And then I'm gonna turn the page of my well-prepared script. See, I'm going quite fast and I like this. I should script more often. Right, okay, this guy, level 161, and actually haven't logged in 161 days. Wow, look at the coincidence. Look at this, this must be a sign. Let's have a look at the kingdom, actually. This guy's kingdom. Nothing too inspiring, I guess. Nothing too inspiring. It also looks like a mess. And, okay, it's called Silate. You know what? The kingdom's name reminds me of a brand of condoms. Okay, a brand of condoms. I'm allowed to say that, am I? But anyway, kick that. Not am I, aren't I? Right, that's the correct grammar. You go, easy, you go. And Jamis reminds me, likes probably something jammed in his iris. Really, ouch, painful. Well, go see the doctor or ophthalmologist. Just learned that word yesterday, actually, when I was writing that script. Anyway, off to the doctors. And then Chaos is a really emo name, I think. And also, Escaperia, I don't know, is it Escaperia? Or is it a scapegoat period? Or is it Scaperia? I'm not about to figure that one out. So, well, Chaos, stay chaotic. And oops, sorry, I was going to kick you. All right, goodbye, have a nice day. Aggie, let's see if the kingdom is ugly, right? Aggie, you know, sounds like ugly. So I guess it's not too tidy. So I guess Aggie means not too tidy, maybe. And it's a sarcastic kingdom. Okay, I don't know. It's I guess you could be a sarcastic kingdom, but shouldn't it be a sarcasm kingdom? Kingdom of sarcasm? It's a sarcastic kingdom. So your kingdom is sarcastic, so the people there are sarcastic. What about a sarcasm kingdom? What would a sarcasm kingdom be? It would be a kingdom of sarcasm, which would be sarcastic. Okay, so I guess both are correct. All right, so, well, anyway, no matter what, I'm going to kick you. So, and finally, Lightmare. I'm going to stop here because Nightmare. Oh, my God, my English is just going down the toilet. Nightmare is just too nightmarish. And I remember it's also an emo name, right? Bahamut, I guess it's okay, right? Kind of generic, to be honest. Nightmare and Bahamut, kind of generic. So, in 2 months ago as well, two months ago, what was I doing 2 months ago? Is that right? Let me kick him first. Kick him or her first. And 2 months ago is October. My mother-in-law went home. I'm so happy just by thinking about it. As you can tell, my wife isn't in. Okay, so anyway, that's it for this episode of Comrade Kicking. I hope you liked the scripted thing, arrangement, and that's it. So I'll kick all these people later. No, I'm going to pick one person to kick now, actually. 1 month ago? RJ, you look like you deserve to be kicked. Let me find a reason, right? So you can tell that when improv happens, it's very, very slow paced. Where is RJ? Hey, whoa, where? Okay, oh, there you go. So I can't even check the kingdom, but anyway, off you go. Goodbye, and that's it for this session. Okay, so that's it for this week's Falco Crusade, and I guess this is the last Falco Crusade podcast this year, and I really plan to do something nice with my channel next year, but you know, really busy, things are ongoing, I have multiple fronts open, which is a bad thing to do if you're a strat up a pigeon, and so... Yeah, oh, I actually didn't realize they changed the art. So this is the Japanese New Year, right? That's what they say, you know, dawn, as opposed to the winter during Christmas time. So, oh, have a happy New Year, everybody. Have a great 2018. Hope there are more fun games. I hope Falco Crusade evolves even more. I'm still waiting for version 1.5, version 2 even. Right, they should, I think they could really, I don't think they'll redevelop the game, that's not my net's, what's that called, modus operandi, you know, like serial killers, yeah, I watch a lot of, what's that called, Criminal Minds and CSI, right, so, anyway, so, have a great weekend, and hope you enjoyed this video, leave me a like and subscribe if you want, actually, if you actually lasted this long. In the video, you probably are already subscribed, and I shall cut it off here. Good night, good afternoon, good morning, have a good year.